Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour.
50 years ago, on this very day, something audacious happened. A human was taken by a mechanical device, a rocket, to the moon. He got out and walked around, and nothing quite as awe-inspiring, I think, has happened in the decades since. The event remains one of the most iconic in modern American history. Reporter Omar Jimenez now reports from Cape Canaveral, Florida.
They are words seared.
It's one small step for man.
Into world history.
One giant leap for mankind.
And in Chicago, at Adler Planetarium, that history is being remembered.
Today is the day of the actual landing when Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin walked on the moon.
This weekend, visitors are invited to take their own steps inside of history.
Even if you weren't alive during that time, it's fun to look back.
Celebrating the 50th anniversary of the moon landing and those behind the Apollo missions.
When Kennedy announced the effort to go to the moon,
Bob Davidson is an Apollo program veteran, a spacesuit engineer, one of the 400,000 people who took part in the mission to the moon.
That was a major issue, to provide the person in the spacesuit the mobility that they have when they can walk around on Earth. That is not an easy task.
A mission shared.
And I wanted to be here in this building on this day for the show.
In the joy of those who are here, like Tom Franke from Minnesota.
You remember when this happened?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I was 13, glued to the TV set like everyone else my age.
A memory that inspired him to go into teaching science himself.
I want my students to get a feel for what it was like for me as a kid, getting caught up in the space race, putting people there, and everything worked. It was such a great day.
It's that kind of excitement that seemingly has not faded.
I'm playing an astronaut.
For Lucy Pribble and her big sister, Sarah.
You know what happened 50 years ago today?
No. Neil Armstrong and Buzz something.
Buzz Aldrin.
Buzz Aldrin landed on the moon.
They are big footsteps that Sarah might someday fill herself.
I want to be an astronaut.
But her mission reaches far beyond the moon.
I think she wants to go to Mars.
Yeah, I want to go to Mars.
The place I most want to go to, which is probably impossible, is to go to Uranus.
It has rings and that it has a pretty blue color.
For now, at least, they're content on Earth coloring. While mom and dad
makes me proud.
For me, definitely nervous.
Might be a half world apart themselves on Sarah's galactic future.
I'm good with her going to space. I think it'll be fun.
So in 50 more years, are you going to be the first person on Mars?
Maybe.
At Adler Planetarium, Sean Lewis, WGN News.